morning, good afternoon, good night, wherever you're watching from. Welcome to Assem Live. This is Assem Sports. Bright, shiny, glorious Sunday. And the Premier League games are coming fast and they are coming quick. Mouth-watering clashes are still being delivered as the Premier League is back in full swing. Thank you for tuning in to Assem Sports. This is your one-stop show for critical, analytical, intellectual conversation when it comes to the beautiful game. And the level that has been exhibited, the unpredictability of the Premier League is what we all watch it for. And yesterday, Brighton had a nice, bright, shining level of football for Liverpool where they couldn't come up with the solutions. Jürgen Klopp after the game said it was his worst game of his footballing career. Liverpool was that bad. Let me give you a rundown of the games that went down. Wolves, who played 2-2 with Liverpool in the Emirates FA Cup, played 1-0 against a very strong West Ham team. They've been struggling. And usually it's Adama Traore who is able to get them through. But they found a player called Podence. And Podence the ball into the net. Wolves beating West Ham 1-0. Nottingham Forest, the Wolves of Leicester City. Brendan Rodgers, Jamie Vardy, Kelechi Iheanacho, Patson Daka. You look at this Leicester City squad and you wonder how they are playing so bad. Like, Brendan Rodgers' work, his job, his legacy is on the hanging thread. They lost 2-0 to newly promoted Nottingham Forest. Wonderful game. Brighton beat Liverpool 3-0. Southampton, Frank Lampard, another manager who, it looks like it goes from bad to worse, then it gets worse, then it gets bad. It never gets good for Frank Lampard. And the level at which Frank Lampard played, and to see Frank Lampard is a great coach. Let nobody disappoint you. At which point in time are we going to look at the players on the field and question their mentality? I mean, sometimes managers are blamed, but you have to know that a lot of factors come into play before the game is played. The manager has his role, the board and the ownership. There was a stand of disapproval among the fans, the Evertonian fans. So the board, there's something going on there. But also the players on the field. I mean, Everton needs some good players. You can count if you take out Alex Iwobi and Gordon. And I mean, but if they have a few players, Onana is a good player. But Onana alone cannot save Aston Villa. Anyways, so I mean, Everton, Aston Villa are winning. Everton lost to Southampton. Brentford, Ivan Toney special. Has Gareth Southgate explained to me again why Ivan Toney was not in the English squad? Why Ivan Toney did not go to the World Cup when Ivan Toney has been doing what Ivan Toney does? Ivan Toney deserves the Tonys, the Golden Globe, Oscar, Ballon d'Or. Ivan Toney and Brentford, Thomas Frank, what he's doing at Brentford is just more than just regular. He came into the Premier League with a team from the Championship and he just fits like a glove. And he's beating the top of the top and performing on a high level consistently. I think Thomas Frank deserves a lot of credit for what he's doing at Brentford. They beat Bournemouth 2-0. Those games were yesterday. And now today, Chelsea just finished beating Crystal Palace, a very strong Crystal Palace, 1-0. Finally, Graham Potter gets a win. But you see, I was waiting for the referee's whistle to blow as a Chelsea fan. I just finished watching this game. I was waiting. I was chewing my nails, biting my butt for this game to finish. Because regardless of how Kai Havertz scored, I mean, we won 1-0. At home against Crystal Palace. And don't get me wrong, Crystal Palace is a great team. But we played great, like as usual. Passing of the ball, distribution of the ball, crosses, but the finishing has been our problem. So if Kai Havertz has scored, he missed a lot of chances, he scored one. I'm not excited about this performance that we put up against Crystal Palace, who also have not been their best for these past few games. So we passed the test. Yes, Kai Havertz scored a goal like he's supposed to. But the good news is Chelsea has acquired the Ukrainian striker. What's his name? New Chelsea player from Ukraine. Now that is a good buy. Jan Felix came on in a previous the game against Fulham and got a red card. Chelsea's problem has never been passing the ball and dribbling like beautiful football. I don't care about that. Nobody won the game because they were the most skillful. You have to finish. And for some reason, Aubameyang is not, he came on in a game against this game we just played against Crystal Palace. He has some, I mean, Aubameyang needs game time, but he also needs delivery. So this new Ukrainian player, kudos to the Todd Boehly and the board, what's his name? He's really good. He's really good. He's from Ukraine, he's from Shakhtar Donetsk, I think. Let me find the name real quick. But it's a good buy. It's definitely a good buy. But if Kai Havertz can play striker, Chukwuemeka can play striker, don't tell me that Kai Havertz scored. He's supposed to be scoring. We cannot rely on Kai Havertz, even though he has scored today against Crystal Palace, even though he missed a very nice sitter in the first half. So we've been doing all we are doing. What João Félix came to do is what Ziyech can do. It's what Pulisic can do. It's what Chukwuemeka can do. That dribbling and all that thing, he got a red card. But we have Mikhailo Mudryk, who is Chelsea's new signing from Shakhtar Donetsk. So that is the piece of good news. Today, the London derby is about to go on. Newcastle also beat Fulham 1-0. Alexander Isak is back. And Alassane Isak is heading the ball into the back of the net. Newcastle, very good performance against Alexander Mitrovic, who had a penalty, converted the penalty, but the penalty was denied because it was a double hit. I mean, that game was full of so much drama. The Chelsea Crystal Palace 1-0 and the Newcastle Fulham 1-0 and 11:30 in about 15 minutes. It is about to go down. Tottenham Hotspur against Arsenal. That is a blockbuster game of the day. Thank you for watching SM Sports. Let me know what you think about everything going on. Thank you for your love and support. This is your one-stop shop for critical and analytical intellectual conversation when it comes to the beautiful game. Arsenal is playing Tottenham Hotspur. Sunday football special. London Derby. Thank you for watching SM Sports. The Forecast 1.0, a collection of songs by the Musical King. New ASEM music. Don't forget about that. Click that link in the bio. We'll have a channel coming soon. We'll be back.